Greetings from SRCC Children's Hospital, managed by Narayana Healthcare. I am Dr. Charshnal Rathod, pediatric orthopedic surgeon from Mumbai. And the topic for today's parent education is in toeing or pigeon toeing in children. So most of the times when the child starts walking, the parents have concerns that the child is not walking right. Or maybe the child walks with both the legs turned inwards, or also the parents feel that the child sits with the legs curled behind, which look like sitting like a pigeon, hence the name pigeon toe walking. And this can be a concern for many parents, but let's make it clear today that it is a kind of a developmental problem and growing problem. This usually the child outgrows as the child grows in age. So mainly there are three causes from which this intoeing arises. One is from the foot, which is also called as a hooked foot or a curved foot. Second is from the inward bending of the leg bone, that is the tibia. And third from the increased angle of the thigh bone, that is the femur. So let's look at each of these problems slightly in detail and see how we can find solutions and make the child walk properly. So for the foot, usually when the child is in the mother's womb, because of the position, the foot might be turned inwards. And as the child grows till age 1 year, this foot shape might remodel. Very rarely some plasters or splints are needed to correct this foot in turning. The next reason would be inward bend of the leg bone, that is the tibia. So this is again a developmental problem, and all the kids usually are born with such shape of the leg bones, and this bone remodels or tries to become normal till age 9. And usually we don't recommend any type of shoes or splints or plasters for this problem, because it can actually be uncomfortable and it can at times also aggravate the situation. So coming to the thigh bone, usually the kids, they are born with a very high angle of the thigh bone with the hip joint, which is called the femoral version. So femoral version is the hip bone and the angle which is formed. So this angle is usually very high in kids. It is around 40 degrees or so in kids. And as the child grows, it comes to a normal of around 10 to 12 degrees. So we as adults, we have an angle of 10 to 12 degrees. And because of this higher angle, the kids have a tendency to walk with toes inwards. And also they have a tendency to sit in the W position. So usually the treatment, as I mentioned, is we need to just get away or overcome the habit of W sitting, and that can be easily achieved by encouraging the child to sit in a cross leg position or sit in a 90-90 position, that is on a chair or table. And this will just help us to get over this habit and also improve in the remodeling or modeling of the angle, which occurs till age 11. So it is not much of concern, but of course, yes, walking or running with an intoeing gait can cause difficulties in the sports activities in the school, or it can cause frequent falls in the child. And yes, it is a matter of concern. So apart from this basic precautions or just a reassurance to the parents that it is a developmental problem, we do recommend some exercises. So these are basic exercises. So for the inward foot, which is the foot which is turned inward, a stretching of the feet outwards, that can be done. And for the leg bone, we don't recommend any exercises as such. Whenever the child walks with toes turned inwards, the muscles on the outside of the thigh, they are kind of turned more inside and they need a stretch. So this exercise basically helps to stretch the muscles. And as you see in the illustration in the video, the child lies in on the belly. Maybe you can give a mobile or start a TV so that the child is distracted. Bend the knee at 90 degrees and bend the angle of the leg or the thigh to make a figure of 4 over the other leg. And this exercise has to be done at least 10 counts per day, at least twice. And while doing this exercise, the hip should not be elevated. So that is one of the precautions. So this exercise helps us to get the internal toe walking pattern, more into an external pattern, which looks pretty much normal, which the adults also usually walks. This also helps the child in his sports activities and running. And so this was just broadly to explain you what are the causes and how can we go about it. And do not insist on wearing any insoles or plasters or any sort of splints, because they are quite inconvenient for the child and they make the child irritable, as well as they take away the playtime of the child, and we don't encourage such things unless the deformity is really bad. We have a wonderful set of physios at SRCC Children's Hospital at the Child Development Center, and certainly we can guide you through all the exercises which I have just explained in short. And also, we are always here to help you to make your child walk normal. Thank you.